Hello guys, Igor here, doing one more AppSumo comparison, and let's compare DinoRank with Seodity. Then you can see which tool is better for your use case. Sometimes a tool is better for some kinds of use case and other tool is better for other use case. That's normal. And then so let's check out how they differ and how they are similar. So both are SEO content all around tools with a focus on keyword tracking. And as you can see here, towards the limits, you get better limits as Seodity if you buy a higher tier. But you have more limitations towards the keywords when you compare with Seodity, and I'm gonna show you. Here is Seodity, and you can see here that you get more keywords per tier. But they have a limitation towards the number of web pages that are crawled on their one page SEO audit. However, if you get the DinoRank, they only have 100k web page limitation, a limitation that you will only find on the license tier 4 of Seodity. Let's compare both tools. Oh, here is Seodity. The user interface of Seodity is better than DinoRank, so they are winning in that case. And Seodity has a feature that DinoRank does not have. That is the backlink tracking. DinoRank only has a manual backlink tracking that you need to manually paste the backlinks that you want to track to see if you're gonna if you're losing or getting the backlinks. And here you can see that automatically Seodity will find your backlinks and track it for you. You can see the backlinks, the anchors, and the referring domains. Now let's compare both rank tracker and keyword research, but now it's starting with Seodity. Seodity does not have any limited of keyword research, and DinoRank has. But let's see the difference here. Those are the data that you get with the rank tracker of Seodity. You get the change, the rank, the URL, your best, the keyword difficulty, the CPC, and the search volume. If you click here, you can get also the suggested keywords and the Google results. You can see the Google results inside Seodity, which is pretty cool. Towards the keyword research, they do not have any limitation. You can research unlimited amount of keywords with no issue. You can see that currently I have the license tier 2 of Seodity. I'm searching here the keyword AppSumo. Let's see what I can find. So keyword difficult 60, the CPC, pretty expensive CPC, search volume, and then you get other kinds of tools. What's AppSumo? You can see that a good CPC here as well. Keyword ideas, related keywords. Okay, those are the related keywords. Makes sense. Now let's do the same thing in DinoRank. Here I'm inside DinoRank. Let's see the rank tracker. Let's call it position tracking here. See what you get. You can highlight, you can see by cannibalizations, download the reports, usually the same thing here. But here you get the keyword volume, the same features, the home, the better. But you get that real search here where you can see the search intent. So the search intent, and that will show you which kind of results shows up on the first page of Google. If it shows up questions, if shows up videos, only image or none of them, you're gonna find in that rank tracking, and you don't find that on Seodity. You can see your competition as well, but you don't get the Google SERP here. You don't get the Google SERP. Let's check now the keyword research. Let's search the same keyword, which is AppSumo. And remember, here on DinoRank, we have keywords limit, keyword research limit. So here you can see the difficulty, the CPC, in the search volume, stating that it's less difficult than on Seodity. You get that tracking here, as you can see, and you get suggestions as well. If you click here, you can see the trend for each keyword. Apparently, here on DinoRank, you get a more in-depth result. Now, let's see the difference in the SEO audit on page, starting with DinoRank. So, in DinoRank, you're going to get a summary of your key metrics. If you have duplicate titles, H1, posts without descriptions, without H1, and you're going to get those features here. States, titles, H1, meta descriptions, meta robots, low URLs. One can see my slow URLs here. In links, HTTPS, and Miro URLs. So you can audit those, and you can also download the PDF report. Let's check out on SEODit. On SEODit, you are going to get a more in-depth result stating if you have broken image broken. You can get your performance as well with DinoRank. Does not give you. So overall, you have a more in-depth on-site research inside SEODit, and the backlinks automatically tracking your website, which is a unique feature as well. That Content Explorer, comparing your domain with your competitors and comparing the keywords, are unique on SEODit as well. So those are the SEODit overall, and also you can discover new keywords as well here, and you check your organic traffic, etc. And now let's see DinoRank. DinoRank has a lot of unique features, and I'm going to show you some of them. You can find my full DinoRank review showing each feature. So here you can see by keywords, which are the best words, the prominent words that you need to use to rank your blog post on the first page on Google. So it's like a more surfer SEO tool that you don't find on SEODit. You have also a lot of graphics to see your authority, your internal linking. Those graphs features are not inside SEODit. You will only find that in DinoRank. As you can see here, how your website is organized. You can also link your Google Search Console and Google Analytics in DinoRank, and you can't do that in SEODit. You can see keywords, opportunities, and tips about how to better rank in some of your blog posts. And you can analyze your position and keywords. Just add your keyword here and click on search. You are gonna see each of your URLs on your website, and you can see all the keywords that you are ranking for in that blog post. This is super useful, and you don't have that feature. You have an organic traffic feature, but not so in-depth in SEODit. So DinoRank has a much better organic traffic feature than SEODit. About cannibalization, to see if you have posts that are one competing with the other, and you can just stop that cannibalization and choose one of them to rank for that keyword. You can also enter a domain or a URL, and DinoRank will see your estimated traffic for that blog post. It's a unique feature that you only find in DinoRank as well. In content detections, where you can find the blog posts that are not getting traffic, you only can find that in DinoRank. In external link management, it's their backlink feature that is not so useful, because you need to add manually the backlinks that you want to be tracked, and DinoRank will track those links for you. They don't have a limit, as I see, for that external link management, so that's a good thing. You could use, for instance, SEODit to discover your links and then paste here on DinoRank, so DinoRank can track it for you. So the tool, they complement itself. What I'm going to do, I like those SEO tools, and I have SEO ranking as well, and I think they cover different kind of topics, and if you work with them together, you can get better results. And since SEODit has that backlink feature that's super useful, what I did is downgraded my SOG it from tier 3 because it was expensive to tier 2. And then I bought DinoRank tier 2. Then I had, you know, like both two for the same price. So I would recommend you, if you, you know, you don't have an agent, if you can, if you are working with your brand, which is my case, that's super useful and good limits. If you get DinoRank tier 2 and SOG it tier 2. Then you're getting, you will get the best value for both too. And I would recommend you to keep both. I have added both links in the description. Remember, you have only one day to get SEO audit. You only can get it today. So go on, take a look at both tools. And if you like it, please click on the link in the description to help me to keep going. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.